Okay, so as you know, we have always been seeing, I mean, different words and adjectives in Portuguese, and we are seeing them in singular, singular, and plural, plural. There are some rules to know how we make the plural of the nouns e similares, nomes, and adjetivos, se falar. Okay? How do we make the plural? So these are the basic rules. We are on page 48, okay? Do livro português já. Página 48, livro português já. So these are the main rules. And we have a table here, short table, with the main rules. They follow an order of the most common rules to the least common, which means most of the times the rule is this one, and then it's this one, and then it's this one, and until the last. Okay. So what is the most common rule to make a word that is singular to plural? Every time a word ends with a vowel, what means a vowel? Vogal. A, E, I, O, U. Okay? E, A, O. Every time it ends with a vowel, we just add an S. Okay? Se ekliorus çoğuluyor. Okay? Then we have the plural. That's it. Peixe becomes peixes. Peixe means balık, peixes, balıklar. Caneta, kalem, canetas, kalemnes. Sumo, okay? Sumo is juice. And sumos, the plural. So this is the rule every time we have a word ends with a vowel. Can be other also other words, for example, livro, which becomes, sorry, let me just, which becomes livros. Another one, árvore. Árvore means arch, okay, tree. Árvore becomes árvores. Planta, which means plant, okay. Bitki becomes plantas. Cidade, cheias, cidades. Okay, so quite easy. Every time it ends with a vowel, the rule is we just add one S to the word. This is the first rule. Second, every time we have words that end with an S or an R, we add a S. For example, país. País means ülke, okay? Country. Becomes países. Professores, okay? Or that man or professor becomes professores. So every time you have a word ending with an S or an R, you add a and S. Now, we come to the most tricky one, okay? This one is very interesting. Every time we end with this sound, that it's actually a bit hard to say, okay? It's in Portuguese grammar, this is called ditongo, which means that it's two vowels together. Two vowels together in Portuguese, it's called ditongo. So, and especially this one who has this little wave on top of the word, which we call til, okay? We read it like M. Some of the words we have seen, like the name João or the word pão, which means ekmek, okay? Now, why is this complicated? Because sometimes this M becomes ãos, so you just put an S, so it follows this rule because it ends with the O. but sometimes becomes ange, and some other time becomes oinge. What is the rule? There is no rule. You just need to know. After you know more and more words, you will remember, you will know that some of them will end as ange, some of them will be ange, and some of them will be oinge. The reason for this, very briefly, because it's not very important for now, I mean, this type of class. But the reason for this, it's about the history of the Portuguese language. That actually, the origin of this ditongo, it comes from a sort of mistake. Not a mistake, but an error. So it became a way of saying some words that passed to writing without following grammatical rules. Back then, I'm talking 16th, 17th century. But what happened is that since this was not a formal, official grammatical rule, then through the time, they started to make people in the speech, in their oral speech, they started to make the plural of ang as ange, ange, and oinge without no rule because it was not an official grammatical rule. And with time, according to the phonetics, what sounds better, what became to be the dominant sound, some words became ange, some words became ange, and some others became oinge. So there's not really a grammatical rule for that. Okay? It's quite hard for someone who is learning the language like you. But as the time passes and you know more and more words, you know that this one ends with ange, this one ends with ange, and this one ends with ange. For example, cidadão, you just put an S. Cidadão means citizen, okay? Or vatandas, okay? Citizen, citizens, cidadãos. Alemão, you know this, Alman, okay, German, Alemães, okay, Almanlar, Germans. Avião means uçak, okay, plane, aviões, uçaklar. Okay, so we have three words that in the singular, they are all ang, but in the plural, they have different terminations or suffixes. For example, I can give other examples. Pão, okay, which means ekmek, okay, bread, becomes pães. Cão becomes cães. Associação, a very long word. Associação means dernek, okay? Dernekles, okay? Associations, it's associações. So I cannot really tell you that this form it's more common, this form is more common, this form is more common. No, there is different forms according to different words. So as we what I advise you to do is every time you see a word with m, okay, ending with m, and when you know the plural, you can ask me or you can check online, just make a note and then you know. Step by step, you start to memorize. Now, let's go to other rules. Every time a word ends with al, el, or ol, we cut the l and we add es. So, animal, which means Ivan, becomes animais, Ivanlar. Papel, cut, okay, paper, becomes papéis. Espanhol, which means espanhol, okay, a Spanish a woman or a man, espanhóis. So what you do is basically you take off the L and you add ES. Now, another rule, this is very, very uncommon, okay? So these are very few cases like this, but just to tell you, if a word ends with il, The il goes and you add as, or the el goes and you put an s. But these are very rare cases, like fossil becomes fosseis. And finally, every time a word ends with m, we take off the m and we put ns. Like garagem, garage becomes garagens. Homem, Adam, okay, man becomes homens. And these are basically the rules. You can also check them on page use on ED 117 do livro Gramática Ativa. You have some cases here, okay? So when you put an S, the case for ditongo ão, what I told you, the case for L, for M, for R, S, and Z. You also have it here, the rules. You can check the rules from this page. Use on ED 117. Okay, so let's do some easy exercises. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 sentences, 8 frases. Preciso de 8 pessoas. I need 8 people to try to do this. Would like, okay, we have 2 already. Três, we need 5 more. Okay, we have 5 already. Mais 3 pessoas.
Also, we have Birsen Hanım and Canan Hanım. Also, Mustafa Bey.
Ah, so we okay, we have already 8. Okay, Maryam, you can decide who starts. You can be early.
Of course. Serap Hanım, buyurun.
Bom dia.
Bom dia.
A Fernanda com 2 paus ao pequeno almoço.
A Fernanda come 2 pães ao pequeno almoço, ok? So, it's the second one, pães, ok? A Fernanda come 2 pães ao pequeno almoço. What does this mean? Fernanda eats 2 pieces of bread at breakfast, ok? Muito bem, a Fernanda come 2 pães ao pequeno almoço. Próximo. Next one.
Canan'ın buyurun. Canan'ın mikrofonunuzu açabilirsiniz.
Ok, obrigada. Ao jantar, o Ricardo bebe sempre 2 copos de água.
Muito bem. Muito bem. Obrigado, Jana. Ao jantar,
Fernanda?
é dinner. O Ricardo bebe sempre, he always drinks, 2 copos de água, 2 glasses of water, ok? Aqui, subarda, yeah, 2 glasses of water. Copo means barda, copos, barda, claro, ok? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Ah, okay.
Okay, Demet Hanım, buyurun.
Os galões são uma mistura de leite e café.
Os which one do you think it is?
Galões.
Galões, yes, galões, muito bem. Galão, it basically means sutucave, ok? Galão, it's, you can say café com leite, for sutucave, com leite, but it's also known as galão. Okay, so you can go to um galão, I would like a galão, which means café leite, ok? Sutucave. São os galões, são uma mistura de leite e café. That's precisely what says here. They are a mix of, okay? Muito bem. Próxima.
Mustafa Bey, buyurun.
Este restaurante organiza cantares de grupo fabulosos.
Muito obrigado, Mustafa. Este restaurante organiza jantares de grupo fabulosos. Muito bem. This restaurant organizes group dinners or fabulous or great group dinners. Muito bem, obrigado. Próximo.
Eylem Hanım, buyurun.
Uşpudinç Daminia May Sal Aminia Sobremesa Favorita.
Muito bem, Eylem. Os pudins da minha mãe são a minha sobremesa favorita. The puddings of my mother are my favorite dessert. Ok? Sobremesa means dessert. Obrigado. Próximo.
Birsen Hanım, buyurun.
Olá, bom dia.
Bom dia, Birsen.
Estes ananases ainda estão verdes. Verdes.
Muito bem. Estes ananases, viradores, estes ananases they are still green, so they are not ready.
Ainda.
Ainda. Ainda. Obrigado. Próximo.
Gamze Hanım, buyurun.
Bom dia, professor.
Bom dia, Gamze.
Há boas críticas a esta galeria em vários jornais.
Jornais, muito bem. Jornal means gazette. Jornais, gazeteras. Okay, so há boas críticas. Há means vars. There are good critics, good reviews, if you want. A esta gelataria, gelataria means dondurmadja, okay? It's ice cream seller. A esta gelataria, it comes from gelado. Ice cream means gelado. Em vários, several, ok? Em vários jornais, in several newspapers. Muito obrigado. Última.
Hülya Hanım, buyurun.
Bom dia, professor.
Bom dia.
Quando tomou o pequeno almoço no jardim, quais uns sons paregam o jantar de Roxane Nelis?
Quando tomo o pequeno almoço no jardim, ouço uns sons, parece o cantar de Roxane. Okay? So the L falls, okay? And we add is Roxane. Roxane, I was just checking, it's a bird. I checked the translation, in Turkish it appears Gurgun. Okay? In English is nightingale. I don't know. It's a bird who sings very well. Quando tomo pequeno almoço no jardim, when I have breakfast in the garden, jardim means bache, okay? Ouço uns sons, I hear some sounds. Parecem is like benzior, okay? They look like, they sound like o cantar, the singing of this bird, Roxinóis. Okay? Roxinol is singular, Roxinóis is plural. Muito obrigado a todos. Now, let's do a bit more complicated, not complicated, but it's a more complete one. Okay, what we have to do here is we have uma, duas, três, quatro frases, four sentences, and we have to write them again, okay? That's what means this word, reescreve, okay? write again as frases no plural. Write the sentences in the plural again. So I would like to have four people, and preferably four different people to do this exercise. Okay, set up. If you didn't do it yet, if you didn't participate in this exercise, I welcome you to participate in this one, okay? But if it's the same people, nothing to do. Okay, we have four. Let's see if anyone else would like to. Okay, let's go with these four, not to lose more time. Mariam, you can choose as you wish, so we can start.
Okay, sir. Serap Hanım, buyurun.
Elas tomam dois chávenos de leite e comem dois touradas ao pequeno almoço.
Muito bem. Just a small, small mistake. There are two numbers in Portuguese with F gender. Only two. The first, um can also be uma, and dois can also be duas. The other numbers don't have gender. Only these two. Okay. So uma, dois, duas. So that's why it's not dois chávenas, but duas chávenas de leite. Elas tomam duas chávenas de leite. Chávenas, it's finjan, okay? This cup, milk cup. Elas tomam duas chávenas de leite e comem duas torradas ao pequeno almoço. Torradas is like toast, okay? So they drink two cups of milk and eat two toast at breakfast. Muito obrigado, será? Próximo. Next one.
Elim Hanım, buyurun.
Estes restaurantes não têm secaus de fumador. I don't know. It's secau. It's tricky.
It's like secções. Okay. It becomes
secaus.
De fumadores. Okay, or the fumadores, if you want to look. Secção is like section, it's like a part of a place. Smokers room, smokers place. These restaurants do not have a smokers site, smokers part, or a part for smokers. Okay, secções. Secções means sections in English. It's actually the same word in English. Obrigado. Próximo, next one.
Melanie, buyurun.
Olá, bom dia.
Bom dia.
Ela pede sempre dois pães com manteiga e dois sumos de laranja natural ao lanche.
Muito bem, está correto, mas we have also to change the person. So, not ele, but eles pedem sempre dois pães com manteiga e dois sumos de laranja ao lanche. Lanche, it's like a meal between ODME and Akshamemi, okay? Between lunch and dinner. It's like you eat something, have a snack in the middle of the afternoon, okay? We call it lunch. Eles pedem dois pães com manteiga e dois sumos de laranja ao lanche. They ask always for two bread with butter and two orange juice at this meal. Muito bem. Última, last one.
Özlem Hanım, buyurun.
Olá, Eu como dois pesas de fruta de duas horas.
Mm-hmm. You could also put nós. So you could also say we. But no need to change eu. Eu como duas peças de fruta, two pieces of fruit, every 2 hours. De duas em duas horas, duas em duas horas means every 2 hours. Ok? Muito bem. Obrigado a todos. I think we have a question from Bushra.
Olá, bom dia.
Olá, bom dia.
My question is on the example C. Elish pedem.
Mm-hmm.
Is it related between that we learned before R, R, ir?
Yes, it's about the verbs. Okay, so if we go and check the verbs, the verbos regulares, let me find it. Where is it? What is the page? Okay, página 12. You can see here, es, what is the termination? Em. So,
okay.
Ele bebe, eles bebem. Okay? Because it ends with em. Or in this case, ele pede, eles pedem. Okay?
So it means the sentences is a present simple.
Yeah, it's present simple. Yes.
Precisely. Okay. Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. So we were in page 48, I think. Mais perguntas? Any more questions? No? Okay. So, for home, for now it's not very important. What you can do, you can complete the next two exercises at home. Because this is about vocabulary, so you can check on the dictionary, you can check on your own, online. But I can just tell you about these groups of food, okay? These groups of food. Frutas means meivé or meivelés, okay? Fruits. Carnes, it's meat. Okay, etlés, bebidas, it's a check there, okay, drinks, legumes, cereais, vegetables, and tatulás, sweets, or desserts. You can check this, okay? What is the exercise? In every of the groups, there is two names, that are intrusors. They shouldn't be in this group, okay? So you need to find for each of the group which ones should not be in this group. And then you need to write if these words belong to these categories. Mariscos means seafood. Peixes, you know, balaclar, okay, so fish. And queijos. Queijo means Danish, so cheese. You can put them in these groups. And at last, you can also check these different drinks or foods or desserts. These are different drinks or desserts or Portuguese food. And you can put them if it's starters, okay? Starters, entradas, Ana e Meclés, pratos do dia, if it's carnes, peixes, sobremesas or bebidas, you can put them here as well. So this is a way also for you to learn some vocabulary to check on your own, because we have to pass to something more important now. We will see the, na página 82, página 82, Sexaniki, do Gramática Ativa, vamos ver os possessivos, the possessive pronouns. What does this mean in Turkish? Benim, senin, onun, bizim, sizin, onları. Okay? Mine, yours, theirs, whatever. We will see the possessivos. They are called possessivos, okay? Because it comes from the word poss, possession. Okay, let's start. First, we will see only for the first and the second person of the singular and plural, which means benim, senin, sizin, the singular sizin, okay? If it's just one person, the formal way, bizim, and plural sizin and onların. Okay, we will see this. Then we will pass to the others, onun, okay, or theirs. So let's start with the first one. For eu, for benim, we have two groups, singular and plural, masculino and feminino. This is nothing new for you because it's always like this with Portuguese. So let's imagine for the word livro, okay? Benim kitabım, okay? My book. It would be o meu livro. If it's for caneta, kalem, it's feminino because it ends with a minha caneta. If it's plural, you just put an S in everything. Os meus livros, as minhas canetas. Now, for tu, o teu livro, okay? Senin kitabın, a tua caneta. And the plural, os teus livros, as tuas canetas. Now, for sizin, okay? Você, o senhor, a senhora. Mr. and Mrs. O seu livro, okay? Sizin kitabınız, o seu livro, a sua caneta, and the plural, os seus livros, as suas canetas. For biz or bizim, o nosso livro, bizim kitabımız, o nosso livro, a nossa caneta, and the plural, os nossos livros, as nossas canetas. At last, for sizin, but plural, imagine, I'm going to say to all of you in this class, okay? Sizin kitabınız. If it's only one person and you are doing the formal way, it's the same. But in Portuguese, it changes if it's only one or several people. So if it's sizin, the plural sizin, o vosso livro, a vossa caneta, os vossos livros, as vossas canetas. Okay? This is for the first and second persons. For eu, tu, cis, bis, and cis, but the plural cis. Now, one important thing before we pass to the other. The possessivos, okay, meu, teu, seu, nosso, vosso, or minha, tua, sua, nossa, vossas, or the plural of this, they are in accordance, in gender and number, according to the noun, okay? According to the noun, not the gender of the person who says. So, imagine that I want to say, okay, I want to say, my book, benim kitabım, o meu livro. Let me put this bigger. And imagine that Mariam would also want to say benim kitabım, exactly the same. So it doesn't change according to the gender of the person, according to the gender of the noun. So this is the case. Now let's pass for onun and onların. Onun we have obviously, as you know, ele and ela. onların, eles, and elas. Now, there is a big difference between these two. Here, as I said, they agree in gender and number with the noun. But here, it's gender and number with the person, okay? It's different. So imagine that Birsen was going to say to Meryem, onun kitabı, o livro dela. And then Birsen would say the same thing to me, onun kitabı, o livro dele. In this case, it changes, okay? It changes according to the person who owns the object. So dela, it means of her, for Meryem, and dele, it means of him, for José. And another difference is, in all these ones, the possessivo comes before the noun, before the noun. But for these ones, dele, dela, deles, and delas, comes after the noun, okay? As you can see here, o meu livro comes before the noun, but dela and dele comes after the noun. So these are the main differences between these ones and these ones. Before we do exercises, I know this can be a bit confusing. Perguntas, questions.
Canım, buyurun.
My quick question is, livro has a, I mean, it's a general question actually. Isn't it? I mean, we can't say livra because when I see u at the end of the
Yes, so
verb, it's like a masculine verb. And
yes, and when you see caneta, kalem, okay, caneta, it's feminine.
Is it a reason of that you couldn't say Eminia Livra?
Yes, this, if you say Eminia Livro, Livro doesn't change, okay? This doesn't change. Eminia Livro, Minha Livro, it's incorrect. Okay? So, Benim, either if it's for me or for you, Bushra, it's this, o meu livro. But if I want to say, imagine, I'm going to say to Meryem, onun kitabı, for your case, okay? So you own the book, Bushra owns the book, and I'm saying to Meryem, onun kitabı. Then I say, o livro dela. This doesn't change, this changes, because it's for you, okay? But imagine that you are saying to Meryem, for my case, onun kitabı, then it will be o livro dele.
Ok, perfeito. Obrigada.
Nada. Obrigada pela pergunta. Mais alguma pergunta? Any other question? Before we do some exercises. Ok, if you have, after, we will do some one or two exercises now, and then we can have some questions. Please, if you have questions, okay, we have a question from Zela.
Zela, buyurun.
Hola, professor. Last week or the other week, you said you are going to send us the Word file about the question words, but you didn't.
The PDF of questions. Yes, I forgot.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to send today to, Actually, no, I don't have it here, but I will send by WhatsApp to Mariam.
Okay.
And she will share the room. Thank you. Okay.
Thanks.
Obrigado. If you have question, guys, don't write it on the chat. Just speak up. You can ask in Turkish. Okay, we can try to understand each other. No problem. Okay, let's do this one. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I need 10 people for this exercise. 10 people. Before we start, what is the exercise? You have questions. For example, de quem é esta bola? Okay? Bu, top. Okay? Bola means top. Kimi, de quem? And we have to reply according to eu. So what you say, é minha. Why é minha? Because bola is feminine. So your answer is benim. Okay? So é minha. And we use the verb ser for possession. We use the verb ser. De quem são estes óculos? Óculos means gözlük. Okay? Glasses. Okay? De quem são estes óculos? And we have to reply according to ele. So how do you reply? São dele. Okay? Onun. And why we use dele? Because we have ele aqui. So this is the exercise. You have to reply to the question according to the person that we have here in parentheses. So 10 people. We already have one set up. More people. Duas pessoas. When we have 10, 3, we can start.
We also have bir sen hemen canlı, no?
Okay, so 5. Six. Come on, guys. There is 100 people here, or 99. So, a lot of people.
Also, we have Mustafa Bey.
Okay. Sete. We need 3 more. Don't worry. I mean, we are here, all of us, to make mistakes. Okay? If you make a mistake, even better. Okay? So, you learn. Okay, 8. We need 2 more. Okay, Mariam, let's start and then okay. Ah, now it's okay. Now we have 10 people. Okay, we can start.
Mustafa Bey, buyurun.
Üçü mü yapıyorum? Ha, 3.
Evet.
Dekem, aquel, dicionario, e workshop.
Muito bem. Muito bem, Mustafa Bey. Dekem é aquele dicionário, e posso. Ok? Sizin. Muito bem.
Posso.
E posso. Muito obrigado. 4.
Senhora, não buyurun. Seher Hanım, buyurun. Seher Hanım, sesiniz gelmiyor.
Tamam, açtım şimdi.
Evet, şimdi geliyor.
Evet. Sağ ol. Yanlış mı?
Sam?
So.
Okay, Sam, but now we need the possessive. Sam?
No, so.
So. No. What we need is benim. Okay, de quem são estas flores?
Ha, eu.
De quem são estas flores? Yani.
Benim. Meu.
Kimin, okay?
Meu.
No, but flourish, maybe you don't know this, flourish, it's plural and feminino. Okay, so we need.
Okay, minha.
Minhas.
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 São minhas. Okay.
Muito obrigado. Cinco.
Demet Hanım, buyurun.
Okay. De quem é esse lápis? É lápis e teu.
Teu. Ah, sorry. Also, this is an exception. Lápis means pencil, okay? Pencil. And lápis, both okay. The singular and plural of lápis are exactly the same. If it's bir ya da çok, aynı kelime kullanıyoruz, okay? Lápis. But how do you know if this is plural or singular? Because of the verb, de quem é esse lápis? If we would have de quem são esses lápis, then the answer would be são teus. But in this case, de quem é esse lápis, we are only referring to one lápis. So the answer is also singular, é teu. Próxima. Seis.
Sebep Hanım, buyurun.
De quem são estas revistas? São delas.
São deles, muito bem. São deles. Revistas means dergilhas. Okay? De quem são estas revistas? São deles. Muito obrigado. Sete. Next one.
It's me. Okay. De quem são essas malas? São nossas.
São nossas. Muito bem. Bizim. Muito obrigado. De quem são essas malas? São nossas. Oito.
Mustafa Bey, buyurun. Mustafa Bey, daha önceden size söz vermiş miydim?
Evet. Ne yapmıştık? Sekiz mi yapıyoruz?
Pardon, karıştırdım. Kusura bakmayın.
Olamam.
Seraf Hanım, buyurun.
The cane is işte bolu e dela.
É dela, ok? Bolo means cake, e é da pasta, ok? Pasta. De quem este bolo? É dela. Muito bem. Vamos continuar. Let's continue. Last four.
Ok. Canan, buyurun.
De que são aquelas canetas tu e você são ossas?
Çünkü sen ve siz, yani siz yapıyor, okay?
Obrigada.
Tu e você são.
Gül Hanım, buyurun.
De quem é esta chave? É dela.
Dele. Dele. De quem? According to, when we use dele, it's according to ele or ela, not according to the noun. So, de quem é esta chave? Chave means anartaz. É dele. Onuno. Muito obrigado. Onze.
Emelia, não me vejo.
De quem é esta café? É dela.
This is for você. So this is for você, not for vocês. For você, we use seu, sua, seus, suas. So which one use?
E você é sua?
But café, it's o café. So we use...
Ah, it's masculine.
Masculine, yes, muito bem. É seu. De quem é este café? É seu. Ok? Sizinho. Muito bem, obrigado. Última. De quem são estes chocolates?
Eylemanın buyurun.
Sao nos sos.
Muito bem, muito bem. Çünkü ben ve sen biz yapıyor. Então, sim. Nós. São nossos. Muito bem. Bizim. Muito bem. Agora, para casa, for home, please don't try the 39.2 because it's with past tense, que é chamissama, and we didn't learn, but you can try the 39.3. Okay? Just follow the example and you can try it. And then we can correct next class. Okay, and that is all for today. Now we can go for questions. Perguntas, questões.
Merazan'ın buyurun.
Hola, professor. I want to ask about the dilly, dilly, dillish, because I didn't understand when I should use dilly and when I should change the meu, minha.
Okay, so let me go back to the other book. Let's close. Okay. So we use meu, minha, meus, minhas, or teu, tua, teus, tuas, for these ones. For eu, ben, tu, sen, você, sis, but when you refer to only one person as sis, okay, so the formal you, bis, nós, and sizin, and sis, the plural sis. Okay? These are the forms. When do we change between masculino or feminino? According to the object. For example, if I say benim kitabım, o meu livro. Why? Because livro, the word livro, is masculino. If I want to say benim kalem, caneta, a minha caneta, because caneta is feminino. And it's the same logic for all of this. Okay? We put the possessivo before the noun and according to the gender and number of the noun. If it's livro,
darling.
If it's livros, so plural, os meus livros. About dele and dela. We use for ele and ela, which means onun, either if it's a man or a woman. If it's ele, onun, but for a man. If it's ela, onun, but for a woman. If it's eles, it's the same thing, onların, but for men. If it's eles, onların, but for women. When do we use dele, dela, deles, delas? The same thing as here, but we use this not according to the gender of the object, but according to the gender of the person who owns the object. Imagine I am talking with Maryam and I say to Maryam, her book, your book. Okay, her book. I'm talking with Maryam about you, and I say, este é o livro dela. This is her book. But imagine that instead of you, I'm talking about Mustafa Bey. Then it would be, este é o livro dele. Okay? This dele and dela, it's not according to the gender of the object, but the person. This is the main difference between these ones and these ones.